Deputy Catherine Murphy, thank you.
Taoiseach, I too want to express my revulsion at what I saw last night on the RTE Investigates. And while I've got to say it sickened me, I can't honestly say I'm hugely surprised. The culture of non-compliance and the absolute absence of effective enforcement ensures an utter lack of transparency in Irish corporate and political life. It's a system that the public instinctively mistrust. The banking inquiry, the Cregan inquiry, the Fennelly inquiry, the Moriarty Tribune, round and round we go, Taoiseach. And we'll keep doing that until the penny drops. But unless we implement an effective modern system with real consequences, nothing will change. The lack of consequences absolutely drives people nuts. The refrain is, Asher, nothing will change, nothing ever changes, or nothing ever happens. There are no consequences. I hear that over and over again. And I don't know how many times I've heard people say to me in the last year, and particularly in the last year, that they had expected, genuinely expected a change after 2011, when you promised them a democratic revolution and that you would end toxic political culture. But it hasn't changed, and we saw that last night. Last Friday night you wrote to me regarding the problems with the Cregan inquiry, the investigation into IBRCN transactions, including Siteserve and Topaz, which has been in the news recently. With respect, Taoiseach, the letter appears to be kicking these issues to touch, given that the measures require emergency legislation, which doesn't appear to be on the agenda, at least for the foreseeable future, certainly this side of the general election. In the same way, the legislation to tackle corruption, like that seen on the primetime programme last night, is pushed beyond the general election. The story never changes. Lots of words, but Taoiseach, what we really need is action. In recent days, we've seen Topaz sold at a significant profit by the person who purchased it at a significant discount from IBRC, the same person who acquired Siteserve from IBRC at a significant discount. At the same time, he was one of the biggest debtors of IBRC. Both of these transactions were flagged by the department officials as being included in the six large transactions that had serious concerns about the poor quality of decisions made by the IBRC board. And my questions are, Taoiseach, given that the Mahon Tribunal in 2012 found endemic and systemic corruption in Irish political life, and the 2011 Moriarty Tribunal was critical of the political culture and clandestine donations, it's hard to be shocked by last night's RTE Investigates. So when are we going to accept that a new regime is required to tackle corruption in Irish life? And Taoiseach, tonight we have a private member's motion, and
thank you,
the
Deputy.
Subject will be an anti-corruption agency, a document that the Social Democrats published, in which I sent you last week. It will be very interesting to see if that's taken, or if there's amendments made to that, because that's the kind of system, Taoiseach, that's in place in other countries.
Thank you.
Where corruption has been identified and where there has been a comprehensive response. Taoiseach, I want to urge you to look at that with a view to accepting that proposal. Thank you.
Taoiseach. Deputy Murphy, obviously the situation that arose in respect of the case that you mention happened in the House here, and to define a response to it, where the entire Oireachtas wants an answer to the question, and obviously following the case made by quite a number of deputies, a facility was put in place, and Justice Cregan made his determination in respect of particular aspects of that. I'm as open to new ideas as anybody, Deputy Murphy, and I look forward to hearing the contributions from you and others in respect of the debate this evening. You'd all like to think that we could have an answer to an issue that's raised immediately. If somebody in the House here makes a comment or a statement or allegation, as the case might be, which is a matter of public interest or public concern, to prove it is actually is actually not that simple. It's an easy thing to make the statement, to actually find a facility to have it proven is the question. Now, you've put forward your views, and I look forward to hearing your contribution this evening. But be clear on this, that the bill that I mentioned to Deputy Adams is one that will bring absolute independence to a regulator to have the authority to oversee, process, evaluate, investigate the issues that may arise in the course of any of the areas that I've mentioned, plus the facilities that currently exist that are completely independent, the CNAG, CAB, the fraud squad, and so on like that. Now, the government clearly condemn all instances of corruption, anti-competitive behaviour, breaches of ethics legislation, breaches of the Companies Act, and all other forms of white-collar crime. We recognise that there's a need, clearly, Eoin Corla, for a strong public standards legislation system and to enforce and to prevent wrongdoing on behalf of either elected or of public officials. Now, the Ombudsman's Act of 2012, the Protected Disclosures Act of 2014, the Regulation of Lobbying Act of 2015, the Freedom of Information Act of 2014, the major overhaul of the Companies Act of 2014 were very major pieces of legislation to put in place a standard and objectivity by which proper business should be conducted. Clearly, the amalgamation of the Competition Authority and the National Consumer Agency into the Competition and Consumer Protection Commission, I think we're a worthy advance also. And there's been quite a number of improvements to legislation enabling investigation and prosecution of white-collar crime, which was occasioned by the Criminal Justice Act of 2011. The improvements, as I said, in respect of the recommendations of the Mahon Tribunal dealing with unethical and indeed corrupt behaviour will come to government hopefully next week. Obviously, they will be introduced in the forthcoming Public Sector Standards Bill and the Criminal Justice Corruption Bill. All of these are areas that cover particular sectors, and they're in the interests of having transparency and accountability, confidence and trust. So, as I said, I look forward to hearing the presentations and indeed the contributions from you and your colleagues. But we do need a system that is able to provide answers to questions. And obviously, given that we went on a particular route here at Eoin Corla, arising from legitimate queries and questions of people, it's never as easy to find and prove an answer as it is to make a comment or give a piece of information to the House.
Deputy Murphy.
Yep. Taoiseach, the one thing that you've listed off a lot of legislation there, but what we have is a fragmented response to actually enforcement that is fairly toothless, and this keeps on happening. I just looked at, for example, the Moriarty and the Mahon Tribune. Both of those combined cost over €200 million. And at the same time, didn't flag, or we didn't produce a response that is capable of, or an organisation that is capable of dealing with that. And indeed, we're still waiting. The official line in relation to the Moriarty Tribunal is that the DPP, or the government, are waiting for guidance from the DPP on whether or not to proceed with a full investigation. Yet the statute of limitation runs out next year. I mean, this is the kind of thing that absolutely demoralises people. It's one thing having one thing having legislation. We need an agency with teeth that can operate across sectoral response. And essentially, that's what is being proposed. And Taoiseach, I'm asking you, will you accept the proposal tonight? And given that tomorrow is International Anti-Corruption Day, I've got to say I think the response to the proposal that we're putting forward will be very closely scrutinised, given the revelations last night in RTE, and indeed the ongoing the unsatisfactory arrangement that we have at the moment. Thank you.
Taoiseach.
Well, I share Deputy Murphy's view in respect of corruption and unethical behaviour and corrupt activities and all of that. Obviously, in the state here, we've got completely independent operations with the fraud squad, the CNAG, the Gardaí, and you know, CAB has brought so many people before the courts with a serious amount of money recovered for the taxpayer. Now, I think everybody can agree that you don't want to see a situation where you continue to set up tribunals like the experience that we've had over many years, with an enormous cost to the public taxpayer. People tend to forget these things over a period of years. So you've got your Oireachtas inquiries, you've got your commissions of investigation, you've got your tribunals of inquiry. The recommendations arising from the commission of investigation into unfair activities in respect of write-offs of over 10 million requires some further consideration. And I expect to meet leaders of the different parties about that.
Thank you.
So, as I said, Deputy Murphy, I'm willing to hear new ideas, but the list of legislation that we put in place has gone a great way, gone a great length to providing accountability and transparency. Now, Deputy Shorthorn may shake your head. I'll be happy to hear your contribution about the nature of what you talk about. Everybody, I think, wants to stand over over having answers to these things and prevention, if that's at all humanly possible. So it'll be an interesting debate, and the Minister for Justice will take it for the government, setting out the work that has been done that is in place, and more to follow in respect of the independent regulator and the anti-corruption bill.
Thank you. That completes leaders' questions for today.